Adadanam stinam dantai iridam jachi punaha punaha simad rupa padam bujadhuli swam janma janmani Adadanam stinam dantai iridam jachi punaha punaha simad rupa padam bujadhuli swam janma janmani Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told those who are coming to Gaudiya Math, those who are coming to Gaudiya Math to misuse the divine knowledge, they have no relation with Gaudiya Math. They cannot have, they does not have any relation with Gaudiya Math. Those who are taking shelter of Gaudiya Math duplicitously, those who are coming to Gaudiya Math to misuse the divine knowledge available there, they cannot have, they does not have any relation with Gaudiya Math. Be sure about it. The other day I was speaking, the ultimate goal of our life is to become a dust particle unto the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad. Today is the disappearance day of Srila Jiva Goswami Pad. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada saying, everybody speaking, today is the disappearance day of my Guru Pad Padma. But I think it is the appearance day of my Guru Maharaj. Because nobody can see my Guru Maharaj, but I find my Guru Maharaj inside my heart permanently. This is the secrecy of Gaudiya philosophy, Gaudiya Bhajan. Nobody can understand if they are not enjoying full kripa of Guru Varga. All our Guru Varga, they are in line with Srila Rupa Goswami Pad. Prabhupada speaking, it is the ultimate goal of our life to become a dust particle unto the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad. The other day I was explaining, I was speaking in details about what do you mean by dust particle and what is the valuation of that dust particle. I was speaking all about this. Also, I couldn't clarify this point which I wanted to speak, but I was in hurry, that adau guru padasraya tasmat krishna dikshadi shikshanam. I want to clarify this point first, then I can switch over to Srila Jiva Goswami Pada's disappearance day. Adau Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. I was speaking about this topic. Ancient time, it was a usual rule. The king, they arrange one big sava and they call all big maharajas, big super personalities, they Maharaja, they want to bring them, they used to invite them, and the daughter of king, she is going to choose his own husband. This was the usual rule. Adau Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. Usually we know, we take shelter unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma. When we take Diksha, then we take shelter. But why I give this example? You can remember, Narottama Thakur took shelter unto the lotus feet of Loknath Goswami. What was the procedure? You can remember, Loknath Goswami is a Niskinchan. He never want to make any disciple. So humble that he never want to make any disciple. But Narottama Thakur wanted to accept the lotus feet of Loknath Goswami Pad. But he was not at all ready to accept him as disciple. So you can remember, he wanted to do some seva, secret seva. Morning time, Loknath Goswami Pad used to go to field, because there is no Latin, the usual rules there. Still there in Vrindavan you can find. This is a system. And Narottama Thakur waiting to some place, hiding. And after that, Narottama Thakur used to go there and clean that place very nicely. This way, day after day, Narottama Thakur doing seva. One day, Loknath Goswami thinking, who is doing this seva? Who is keeping mud, nice mud, to wash hand? Who is doing that seva? I must watch. Who is that personality? Then one day, Loknath Goswami waiting, and he was that Narottama Thakur coming, the son of a king, Rasai, at present it is Bangladesh. He is crying and doing this seva. Then Loknath Goswami coming in front of him, embrace him. He was bound to give diksha to him. So you can follow this system. Param Pujya Keshav Goswami Maharaj, same thing. First he meets Prabhupada. After that he is totally attracted. Then he took shelter of Srila Prabhupada. This is the system. This is the system. First of all, you should feel some attraction for the super personality. From heart you can accept that Gurudev, he is my Gurudev. You cannot change your decision. This way you can see Srinivas Acharya, Ramchandra Gopiraj, Samananda Prabhu, they all took diksha this way. But at present, system is totally different. In Haribhakti Vilas, it is written that you must watch your Gurudev if you want to take shelter unto the lotus feet of one sadhu, you must watch him. You try to understand him. Though in material condition, you cannot totally understand, but still you can see, at least watch. The how my Guru Padpadmo, I mean that sadhu doing bhajan all the 24 hours. All the 24 hours you can find one Shuddha Vaishnav doing bhajan. There is no interruption in between. Totally, all the time doing bhajan. Any time, be he is going somewhere, he is eating, taking some prasadam, sleeping, every time, all the time he is doing bhajan. Nairantarya, in Sanskrit it is called uninterrupted bhajan, Nairantarya. Otherwise it is not possible for him to deliver bonded soul. This is the system. That's why I told you. Adho Guru Padasraya Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. Same thing happened in my own life also. I told you. I was searching for my Guru Padpadmo. Where is my Guru Padpadmo? And I could realize my Gurudev is very experienced, very old man. But I don't know who is my Guru Padpadmo. I am crying all day and night. One day I am with all sadhu, I went to Vrindavan, watching, taking darshan of deities, this, that. And one day I enter into one bookstall. I was searching some books. I don't know why I take one magazine and turn up the page. I see one old man, one sadhu. This is my Guru Padma. I don't know who's speaking inside me. This is your Guru Padma, 100%. And this way I accepted Srila Bhakti Pumat Puri Goswami Maharaj as my Divine Master, Guru Padma. This is the system. That's why I told you. But you can remember that Prabhupada speaking, those who are coming with a duplicitous motive to misuse the divine knowledge of divine knowledge, which is available in Gaudiya Math, they have no relation with Guru Padma. They have no relation with Gaudiya Math. Gaudiya Math is transcendental, eternal. Gaudiya Math coming from that eternal abode, Golok Vrindavan. What do you mean by Gaudiya Math? I will have to explain in details, but I have no time now. But know it for sure, Gaudiya Math is the place where Rupa Goswami Pad indicating Dibbat Bindaranyakalpadrumadasimatatnaga Singhasanastu Sisiradha Sri Govindadu Prashilevisebh Manus Marami. That is called Vrindavan. Vrindavan is the place where you can find Radha Govindo, all Sakhis, Manjaris, they are serving Radha Govindo. For their total satisfaction, they are serving. This is the place. Also, you can say Vrindavan is the place where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is served with all of it, with full troops, I mean, paraphernalia. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaur Bhakta Bindu. This is called Gaudiya Math. Where you can satisfy Supreme Good Lord full, mane, totally, that is called Gaudiya Math. Where you can satisfy Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with Sankirtan, Nam Yajna, that place is called Gaudiya Math. Gaudiya Math is the place where you can find all dedicated souls, they are throwing their life, they are sacrificing their life for the cause of devotion, for the cause of devotion there, for the cause of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Seva. For Chaitanya Mahaprabhu they are dedicating their whole life. That place is called Gaudiya Math, where continuously without any stop, without a non-stop Hare Kirtan going on, that place is Gaudiya Math. Now I like to discuss all about Srila Jiva Goswami Pad, the topmost Acharya, Tattva Acharya, as far as Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, Jiva Goswami Pad is a Tattva Acharya for us. There is a big discussion about Srila Jiva Goswami Pad. Out of six Goswami you can find Jiva Goswami Pad. Actually, Jiva Goswami Pad is eternal, Jiva Goswami Pad. In Gaur Lila, he is Jiva Goswami Pad. And in Krishna Lila, in Vrindavan, you can find his Vilas Manjari. Always doing seva, 100%. Rup Sanatan, you heard the name of Rup Goswami Pad, Sanatan Goswami Pad, Anupam. Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad, you know about them. He is actually a nephew of Rupa Goswami Pad and Jiva Goswami Pad. But I should not speak that way. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur never speak that Saraswati, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, he is my son. He never speak that way. And Prabhupada never speak that Bhaktivinoda Thakur is my father. All those idiot people, foolish people, they are speaking this way. They are not knowing anything. Their relation is totally different relation. You cannot understand, you cannot guess. Bhaktivinoda Thakur always respecting Prabhupada. He never thinks he is my son. Many times Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada also speaking about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, about Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada thinking. Prabhupada can see Radharani inside Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He never sees he is my father. This is not the relation. But anyway, I am speaking that those material people, they are saying, he is a nephew of Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad. Actually, he is the son of Anupam. He is the son of Anupam Goswami. Anupam Goswami is the brother of Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad. Junior brother. So, for a long time, Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad, they are doing bhajan very, very secretly. They are the eternal parsad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Rupa Goswami Pad, Rupa Manjari, Sanatana Goswami Pad, Lavanga Manjari. This is their identity, you see. Those who are doing actual Gaudiya Bhajan, they have double benefit. Those who are actually doing Gaudiya Bhajan, they are going to get double benefit. What do you mean by double benefit? They can get, when they are Vastu Siddhi, I can discuss all in details after. You go on doing Bhajan, if you can prove that you are doing Bhajan, 100%, then I can disclose all these secret points. Vastu Siddhi. Sarup Siddhi and Vastu Siddhi, two things are there. Vastu Siddhi means your realization, 100% realization, who is you, you can realize. You can discover your eternal relation with Krishna. What is your duty? You can find. Jive Sarupai Krishna Nitya Das. And in Vastu Siddhi, you can get a separate identity. I can discuss about this point, not now. So you see, when your Vastu, you can attain Vastu Siddhi, you can get double benefit. You can get the seva of Gaurdham, you can get the seva at the same time of Brajadham. How is that possible? Jiva Goswami Pad giving all in details about it. I have no time to discuss about it. So you can get both Gaur Seva, I mean Gaurdham Seva and Brajadham Seva. Both you can get. This is called double benefit. Under the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if you go on doing bhajan, you can get double benefit. And those who are doing Krishna bhajan without the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are also sometimes successful, but they are not getting this facility. Without the guidance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if you can get Krishna prema, it is not actually complete. Follow my point. You can get Krishna. But under the guidance of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, under the guidance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, if you can get Krishna, then it is complete. Otherwise, it is not complete actually. Incomplete. You are getting. But still it is not complete. Actually, point is that there is some fighting about this topic when Jiva Goswami Pad took birth. Nobody can identify exact date. But still, those who are realized soul like Bhaktivinoda Thakur and one gigantic personality is from Samananda Parivar, Vishwambarananda Dev Goswami, and from some other place we get some clue about it. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing some topics on Jiva Goswami Path, Sri Jiva Goswami Path, two topics about Jiva Goswami Path we find in Sajjan Tasani. So we find that actually somebody is speaking that Jiva Goswami Path took birth just the year when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared from this material world. Somebody is speaking. Somebody is speaking that Jiva Goswami Path took birth the same year when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I think it is not perfect. Why? Because from Vrindavan, Banavali Goswami, one big Goswami there, some old papers we get, some documents, that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to Ramkeli, you can remember Ramkeli, North Bengal. Everybody is speaking, why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming to Ramkeli? He is supposed to go to Vrindavan. Why is coming this way? Nobody knows. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking that nobody can know why I am coming here. I am coming to meet Rupa and Sanatan. Nobody knows. Everybody fighting why he is supposed to go to Vrindavan, coming opposite way. Why? Nobody knows. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, nobody knows. I am coming here to meet you too, Rupa Sanatan. We get some clue that time when Rupa Sanatan Goswami came, night 1 o'clock or 12:30 or 1 o'clock, they came, night time, to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And that time actually, Jiva Goswami Path was there with him. That time, Jiva Goswami Path was there. Jiva Goswami Path was there. His age was almost 10 years. Almost 10 years. So there is some controversy actually, fighting going on. Somebody is saying 1440. Somebody is saying 1445. I mean Bangabdo. Not BC. Bangabdo. They are speaking this way. So anyway, Jiva Goswami Path took darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he was 10 years old only. He came with Rupa, Sanatan, Anupam, he came. After that, you know everything, that Rupa Goswami Path lived the service of that king, Hussain Shah, lived. He was the finance minister. And Sanatan Goswami was prime minister. They leave everything. They was bound to take that service. King came and requested them to take this position, this post. Actually, they are less interested about it. King requested them. You are so intelligent. You can do some benefit. You come and take this post, the prime minister, and you take the post of finance minister. This way. But you know Rupa Goswami Path go away, leaving everything, and go to Vrindavan, going to Vrindavan, and at that time, Anupam, the younger brother, was there with Rupa Goswami Path. There. And Sanatan Goswami could not go away because king put you into prison. Somehow he managed to come out, and again he is going to Vrindavan now. But Jiva Goswami Path, he was then very small boy. From the very childhood, everybody could understand that he is going to become a big sadhu, always crying in the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, always doing bhajan, more very small, but still. Bhajan means they are eternal person. Suppose those children they are playing, he is playing with Krishna. He is offering some bhoga, making the deities of Krishna. This way, they are eternal person. That's why I am saying that they are doing bhajan. Otherwise, I already told this sloka, Adho Guru Padasara Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshana, without the shelter of Guru Padma, how he started bhajan? Actually, they are not bonded, so that's why I told this way. Otherwise, I have no right to speak that way. Without Guru Padma, without the shelter of Guru Padma, you cannot start Krishna bhajan effectively. Even you take shelter of Guru Padma, but not perfectly, 100%, not 100%, 50%, then you have no right to serve Krishna. Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Then what is the benefit? Prabhupada saying you can get some Sukriti. Only this much you can get some Sukriti, and that Sukriti can give you backing next life also. So Diksha must be perfect, should be perfect. I mean my submission should be perfect. And Guru Padma, he should be Sadguru, otherwise no chance of getting any Kripa. There is so many points involved. Anyway, Jiva Goswami from very childhood exposed this kind of tremendous bhakti, sometimes crying, getting faint in the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mother, father gone. Uttarupa Goswami, I told you, father means the younger brother of Rup Sanatan. Gone with Rupa Goswami, the two gone. Now, this is the condition of that boy. Then very shortly, he took decision to go to Navadip Dham to get knowledge about Vaishnava philosophy, this, that. He wanted to study in Vrindavan. Because that time, Navadip was the ancient Oxford of India, you know. Anybody reading anywhere, if you don't have any certificate from Navadip, nobody can care. Oh, you are from Navadip? Oh, really? So you are suppose he took decision to come here. By that time, he reading Vyakaran, Alankar, everything, doing very very quickly. After that, he took decision to come to Navadip Dham. And when he came to Navadip Dham, is not so, he is only 16, 17 years of old. Age is not so, very small boy. He came here. After that, Nityananda Babu, that time Nityananda was there, here, in Siva Sangam. Now Nityananda Babu, one day speaking, I think Jeev coming to me. Nityananda Babu sitting in room with all his parshad and speaking with smiling mood. I think Jeeva coming now. In the meantime, some devotee coming and informing, Jiva already coming in gate. Bring him to me. Jiva coming, Jiva crying to see the glory of Nityananda. Jiva Goswami Pad crying. He cannot see. He's crying. Then Nityananda Babu embrace him and put his lotus feet on his head, kissing him, embrace him, bless him. Then after that, Nityananda Babu requested everybody, you all give kipa, do kipa on Jeev. Then after that, you see, Nityananda Babu take him for Gaur Mandal Parikram, Gaur Dham Parikram, not Mandal. Gaur Dham Parikram. Nityananda Babu taking Jiva Goswami and showing, see Jeev, see here my Prabhu used to do this kind of leela. And this is a tree planted by Gaur. This is a place where my Prabhu took birth. This way swaying and Nityananda crying, Jiva also crying. This way traveling in all around, you see, Gaurdham. After doing, Nityananda Prabhu saying, you see, I offer you unto the lotus feet of my Prabhu. Now you go to Vrindavan. Before that, I forget one thing. When Jiva Goswami Pad was in home, when he is crying and getting faint, now and then, in the name of Chaitanya. Then someday night, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with full troops giving darshan to Jiva. Full Sankirtan mood, showing him. I am there, Jiva. Don't think. I am with you. Come to me. Then after that, he took decision to come to Navadvip. And there, first he came to Siva Sangam. Then I already speak. Then after that, Nityananda Prabhu giving instruction, you can go to Vrindavan. But in the way, you can drop in Varanasi. You can get some Vaishnav there. Though Varanasi is Mayavadi place, still a special place. You can get some Vaishnava there, especially the disciple of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, Madhusudan Vachaspati is there. You can have the chance to read something there from him. So, taking instruction, Jiva going there, Jiva drop, I mean, he's walking, no question of dropping, still going to Varanasi. And by that time, Varanasi was totally holy place because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu already, you know. So there he met Madhusudan Vachaspati, and there for some days, Jiva Goswami Pad started reading Bhagavatam and so many important Vedanta. He have had the chance to read there, I mean, study there under the guidance of Madhusudan Bhaji. This is a Leela. They are all coming from eternal ground, but still they manifest it. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also, except Guru. Krishna Bhagavan also going to Sandipuni Muni to read and. This is the system. If Prabhu not swaying, then how we can learn? This is the system. So Jiva Goswami was staying there for some days. He is reading Vedanta, Upanishad, Bhagavatam from Madhusudan Vachaspati. And specially, what kind of Vedanta? What kind of Vedanta? Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving interpretation, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya externally he was exhibiting the Leela of Mayavadi. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was topmost Mayavadi that time. Sarvabhauma, this title is totally all over India. And all over India means automatically it is, I would say, all over world. All over India, topmost Pandit means all over world. Because who is Pandit there in other country? In other country, we cannot expect. So India, he was the topmost. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, you are just Vyaspati. You are just Vyaspati. You are Devguru Vyaspati. So that Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was fighting with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He also used to fight with Gopinath Acharya, a sweet relation between them. Who told you Chaitanya is Bhagavan? Then Gopinath Acharya giving argument. After that, Gopinath Acharya speaking this much, that you see, Ishwarer kipale shayto jahare, shei to Ishwar tattva janivare pare. You can understand, you can know the secret tattva When you can enjoy full kripa of the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can understand. Now you are fighting with me, but someday you are going to understand that who is Chaitanya. Okay, drop this matter. I don't like to hear. Who told he is Supreme Lord? What is the symptom? He is fighting. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu knowing everything because inside he is sitting. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sitting inside you, me, everybody is this. As Paramatma. Then after that, someday, Sarvamava Acharya is speaking, well, you are too young. So Maya can catch you. You better you can come to me, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. To Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is speaking. You are too young. So Maya can catch you. Better you can come to me. I can recite Bhagavatam. I can give you some teaching about Vedanta. Mahaprabhu say, okay, you are so merciful to me. You want to save me. It's good. So Mahaprabhu used to go. And hearing Vedanta. And after some days, after five, six days to continuously he is hearing Vedanta, then Sarvamavataja is one day asking, what you understand or not? You are not speaking anything. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, I cannot understand. Then you don't understand, you should speak me. I can clarify this point. You are not speaking, you are silent, how I can understand? You are not understanding? The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, I can understand the main sutra, but when you explain, then I cannot understand. What? What do you mean? But when you speak the main sutra, I can understand. But when you explain, I cannot understand. What do you mean? No, yes, actually I mean. Actually, Vyasadeva writing this sutra, is almost clear. Though I know who is writing the sutra, sutra means is just clue. It's one kind of clue, sutra. Like in mathematics, you know, some sutra, big mathematics we used to do. Big mathematics, small sutra is there. If we apply, we can solve this total mathematics. Higher mathematics is there. The sutra is a clue. So, Mahaprabhu many times speaking this way. In Varanasi also he was speaking in front of Prakashananda Saraswati. That Vyasadeva Goswami writing sutra, so Vyasadeva Goswami can, only Vyasadeva can understand what he mean to say. And all other person, those who want to explain it, they are misguided because they are not enjoying full kripa of Vyasadeva Goswami. So yeah, they are bound to misled. They cannot. This way, Mahaprabhu started giving explanation. Sarvamattajajo fighting with him, giving some argument. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cutting it, one by one, cutting it. Then after that, Sarvamavatajajo could understand. He is Supreme Lord. Otherwise, this way, it is not possible to explain this sloka. One sloka used to this. Then after that, by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he get faint, he fall down. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu touch him. What happens, Sarvamamo? What you see? Why you get faint? Then he is this way. And after that he is speaking. Vairagya vidya nija bhakti yoga Shikshartamekam yapurusho purano Sikishna chaitanya sarira dhari Kipam budiriyastamaham prapade. He is writing 100 sloka like wind. 100 sloka he is speaking. 100 sloka he is speaking like wind by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Like you can remember, Dhruva Maharaj, When Bhagavan, when Supreme Lord came to take darshan of Dhruva. Am I wrong? It is written there in Bhagavatam, Krishna Bhagavan, Supreme Lord speaking, well, wait, I am going to take darshan of Dhruva. And everywhere we know it is the usual procedure, Supreme Lord coming to give darshan. But in the case of Dhruva, it is just opposite. Supreme Lord speaking, well, wait, I am going to take darshan of Dhruva. You see, it is written, Madbhakto Dadarsha, Gachwami. I can go to Madhuban to take darshan of my small devotee, Dhruva. This way. Now here you see, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu now touching him and speaking, Sarvabhauma, what you see? What you feel now? He cannot speak. And in Madhuban, when Supreme Lord came in front of Dhruva, Dhruva wanted to pray. Dhruva wanted to speak something, but cannot speak. He is so small boy, kids. Then Supreme Lord touched his, Shankha, his cheek. Then Dhruva started like fire speaking. Jyantaha pravishyamama bachamivam. It's so nice, loka. So many speaking, Dhruva, like wind. Same thing happened here. When Sarvam Vartajajo, enjoying full kippah Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he started speaking like wind, glorifying the name of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in 100 sloka, like wind. No question of writing, speaking only. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu bless him. Sarvamama, the way you are reciting me, you are glorifying me, 100 sloka, if somebody in future can read and speak this sloka, he can come out successful. It is my full blessing on you. Shato slok kori more je koile stavan. It is written in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Shato slok kori more tumi je koile stavan, je jon koribe ta shravan pathan, kirtan. Who is going to read it or recite it? All they are going to come out successful. From heart, not from tongue. Oh, Dandavad Maharaj, you can speak from heart, not from mouth. You cannot speak from heart. My Guru Maharaj used to say, they are coming to me, Maharaj, Baba, they are coming to me paying Dandavad. So Dandavad mean? Kai man bakyo. Physically, by speech, and from heart. If three condition, if not satisfied, then your dandavad is incomplete dandavad. Kai man bakya. Kai mean physically, man mean mentally, kai man bakya. Man mean also from heart. Because mind mean here, mind is, if mind is not parallel with heart, somebody can say, maybe that mind is material. Okay, but that time when he is paying Dandavad, his mind should be in parallel with heart. Then it is equal to heart. If A is equal to B, if B is equal to C, then A is equal to C. In mathematics, this way. So you see, from heart, you are, if you can recite the sloka, 100 sloka, you are come to successful. This is the commitment by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now, Sarvam Bhattacharya, in front of Sarvam Bhattacharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to explain Vedanta Tattya in a very exact way. Vedanta Tattya. Achinta Vedavat Tattya. Sarvam wanted to cut this Siddhanta and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu establishing this Siddhanta. Nilachali Vedantya Vyakhyan. I also write these small treatises, small books. Nilachale Vedanta Vyakshan, very small. All the total gist of Achinta Veda Vatatya. Simultaneous Ved and Aved. Different and non-difference is there. And that detailed discussion, what took place there, Gopinath Acharya was there. And that Gopinath Acharya, after next life, he took the birth as Baladev Vidyabhushan. Gopinath Acharya was there waiting and hearing. Very carefully. And Gopinath Acharya leave his body and took the birth as Baladev Vidyabhushan. We heard from him. As per Gaudiya Siddhanta. And that Vedanta Siddhanta, I mean what Sarvam Vatajaja got from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, received from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sarvam Vatajaja, that knowledge, that Siddhanta, that Tattva Vedanta Vakshan, totally giving to his important disciple, number one disciple, who is Madhusudan Vachaspati. Why I am going to this point? That Madhusudan Vachaspati, now in Varanasi, and Jiva Goswami Pad now have the chance to hear Achinta Vedavet Tata Siddhanta on Vedanta from him. So, by that time, Jiva Goswami Pad was the topmost Vedantist. Nobody was there in this earth, on this world, who can break the Siddhanta of Jiva Goswami Pad. Topmost Vedantist. After receiving this kind of, after getting some knowledge, I mean, studying there in Varanasi, then Jiva Goswami Pad now going to Vrindavan. Jiva Goswami Pad going to Vrindavan there, and after that, he took the shelter of Rupa Goswami Pad, staying in Rupa Goswami Pad, and Sonatan, staying with them. All the time, 24 hours doing seva of Rupa Goswami Pad, Gurudev. All the 24 hours doing seva. Sometime Rupa Pad writing. Hot season is too hot there in Vrindavan, externally. I should use this word. Because in Vrindavan, it is actually very, very charming climate. Because it is already written in Bhagavatam. It is written in Bhagavatam. Sarvakala Sukhavaha. And now if I am sitting in Vyasasana, if I explain this way, then I am speaking wrong. So I should speak this way. In Bhagavatam it is written, Vrindavan. What is the climate of Vrindavan? Sarvakala Sukhavaha. You can enjoy all the time. Vrindavan is very nice climate. But now if you go, it's too hot, Maharaj, 48 degrees. We cannot stay there. It's too cold, Maharaj. We cannot stay. This is the condition. Material people cannot go to Vrindavan. They cannot see Vrindavan. One day, one devotee, so-called devotee, coming to Gauri Sadat Bhaji Maharaj. Gauri Sadat Bhaji Maharaj saying, "From where from you are coming? I am coming from this place. And I already get my return ticket." Then Gaudiya Math was smiling. "You are coming to Dham with return ticket? I never hear this kind of Siddhanta. You are coming to Dham with return ticket. You like to go back? I heard nobody can go back if he is coming to Vrindavan." This way he explained. Nobody can understand the heart of pure Vaishnava. What do you mean to say? Now, Jiva Goswami Pad going to Vrindavan. And there, you see, he is doing all the 24-hour seva. Sometimes hand fan. Pulling hand fan. This way, Rupa Goswami Pad writing. All the time writing this way. This way doing seva. And one day, actually, he is taking lesson from Sanatana Goswami and Rupa Goswami regarding all all top secret, Vaishnava Siddhanta, taking relation from Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana Goswami Pad all the time, doing seva. And one day, Ballavacharya, you know, you can remember Ballavacharya went to Puri, Sikhetra, to meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time he expressed some sort of audacity. I cannot accept the commentary of Sridhar Goswami, but I freshly writing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very angry. Why? You are writing freshly? You cannot accept the Siddhanta of Siddhasaipad? Swami means husband. Those who are not accepting their husband, they are actually pros, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told. Then he became frightened. What? Yes. This way, Ballavacharya ji got feedback. First of all, he meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there in Arail Gram, one village is there, just opposite side of Ganga, Jumuna, Saraswati, Saraswati, three rivers confluence, there Allahabad. If you cross that river, there you can go to that place. The name of that place, Arail Gram. There first, he met. There he met. Rupa Goswami Pad was there that time. And you see, there he got kripa from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But still, he could not digest that kripa. He got kripa to break his vanity, to break his ahankar. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to ask one Brahmin who came to meet him. I can discuss this point after because so many things to discuss, you see. I cannot get time. There, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, through that Brahmin, expressed all Gaudiya Siddhanta, topmost, very. That is topmost. But still, Ballavacharya could not digest it properly that time. Ballavacharya is not ordinary personality. I am not going to insult him. But still, this way, you see, again he is coming to Puri. After that, he is requesting, after getting kripa from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he requested Gadadhar Pandit to give mantra freshly. He took Guru Padma already he was doing Balgopal Bhajan. Balgopal, you know? Balgopal Bhajan. Already he took mantra. But he wanted to take Kishore Gopal mantra. Kamgayatri Kambi. He wanted to get from Gadadhar Pandit. Gadadhar Pandit was not at all ready. Gadadhar Pandit was not at all ready. I am not ready to give any mantra to anybody. Because my guidance is there, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I cannot break his rules. I cannot give. Repeatedly he is asking and crying. Actually, I heard, it's in there, he got Kishore Krishna mantra from Gadadhar Pandit. Actually, to be frank, he is from our Gaudiya family. But still, we find they are making a new sampradaya, Ballabh sampradaya, Pushti Marg. They are making a new sampradaya, Ballabh sampradaya, Pushti Marg. They are making. And after some time, he was the Acharya of their Sampradaya, Vishnu Swami Sampradaya. He was the Acharya. Vishnu Swami, no, Nimbarka Sampradaya. Nimbarka Sampradaya. He was the Acharya, his Sampradaya. This way, anyway, so that Ballava Acharya, now in Vrindavan, Rupa Goswami Pad compiling one book, and that time, you know, Radha Damodar, now temple place, temple spot, there It is the bank of Jamuna. Jamuna at that time was big. Very. At the bank of Jamuna, that Bhajan Kutir. Then Balavacharya in the meantime came to take bath in Jamuna. And also he had the motive to meet Rupabad also. He came here and he could find that Rupa Goswami was compiling one book. He is asking, what book you are writing? Actually, I am trying to compile Rasamrita Sindhu. Well, you can complete it. I am going to edit that book. I can edit that book. So popped up. He is going, well, I can edit that book. You can compile. You can complete that book. I am going to edit that book. Rupa Goswami says, well, I am very lucky you are going to edit that book. In the meantime, Jiva Goswami was there. Jiva Goswami was playing fan, hand fan. Then after that, he took permission from Rupa Goswami Pad, Prabhu, if you permit me, I am going to take water from Jamuna, because there is no water. Actually, he wanted to follow that Balavacharya in the way. Because Balavacharya was going to take birth in Jamuna. In the middle, in between, he catch him. Excuse me, if you never mind, what fault you found? Find with the books of my Guru Padma. He is saying this kind of fault. Then Jiva Goswami is answering very politely, it is not. There cannot be any fault with my Guru Padma. Then after that, on and on, 1, 2, 3, 4 going on. Then Siddhanta Vishar, in the midway. Nobody could get, Balavacharya could not take bath by that time. Couldn't take bath in Jamuna. And going on, Sasta Charcha. Balavacharya giving argument, he is breaking. He is giving argument, again breaking. After that, Balavacharya become, go mad. Who are you? After that took bath, again coming to Rupa Goswami Path. Rupa Goswami said, why you come back here again? No, actually I have some question. Who is that boy? Who is that boy? Why? No, I'm asking, who is that boy? Actually, there is a small boy. Actually, to be frank, he is in family relation, previous. He is my nephew. Actually, now he is my disciple. A very poor boy is staying with me, very humble. Oh. After that, gone. Then, Balavacharya passing remark, I cannot edit your book, it's so okay, everything. Then Rupa Goswami says, why? Some minutes ago, some words ago, he's saying, I want to edit that book, nice thing. Must be some problem with guessing. After that, he's speaking in front of Jiva Goswami. What argument do you have done with him? Actually, he's staying very politely. No, actually, there is no Siddhanta wrong, this Siddhanta. There is no wrong Siddhanta in your books. And he's, you go away right now from me. You have no right to stay with me. Go out now. You cannot bear this point. He is so big, family from me. He is a big devotee. He is coming here, giving me the chance to edit that book. You cannot bear it. Now out from my place. Who can break the order of Rupa Goswami Pad? Jiva crying and crying, shedding tears. He is going away from Rupa Goswami Pad. He is crying, almost going to die. He cannot die because he need to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He need to serve Rupapada. He need to serve Radha Govinda. He want to die, he cannot die. Now he is going east direction. Now reaching by one place that is called Baigaon. When you do Brajamandal Parikrama alone, Chaitanya, as per the rules of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, ekola jaiva kimba sange ekjon. I can go alone or maybe some sober devotee can, one devotee can stay with me. This is a system of parikham. Thousands of people going with me, I cannot do parikram nicely because with Baba, I am not going to break my Baba. If Baba is there, I can do my parikram nicely. So, by Gaon, there Jiva Goswami are almost fasting. Brajavasis, they come and put pressure on me, almost you must take this, milk at least. This way he is saving his life. We heard from Gaudiya Siddhanta, he compiled Shata Sandarbha there, Gopal Champu, so many books. Then he is going to die because he is fasting, almost fasting. So getting slim and slim, is going to die. By that time, by the mercy of Krishna, Sanatana Goswami are traveling and coming to Udpal, coming to that place. Some Brajavasi asking, "Hey Baba, some devotee coming here, so nice, he is fasting and going to die, he is not taking anything. Who?" Then, "Oh, he must be Jeev. You go and see. What is the condition of you? What Jeev?" Jeev crying and crying and falling down until he doesn't speak. He cannot speak anything. Sanatana embracing him. "What happens? Jeev, what happens?" Then Jiva Goswami Pad going to narrate everything. "This is the condition. I was bound to give some argument in front of Balavacharya ji. But my Gurudev couldn't. My Gurudev speaking me, 'You go away from me. This is the condition. So I come. I like to die.' 'No! You have so many seva. Come with me. Let me see.' Then he is coming to Rupa Goswami Pad and speaking, 'Rup, Jivedaya, this word you like to put in books? Jivedaya, you like to show Kripa, Karuna for Jiva, this word you like to put in dictionary? You cannot express? What do you mean? Why you drive him away? Why?" Then Rupa Goswami Pad was bound to accept again and give seva, full seva. Then after that, Jiva Goswami Pad getting the seva of Radha Damodar. Actually, Radha Damodar was installed by Rupa Goswami Pad. And that seva was given to Jiva Goswami Pad. Because Rupa Goswami Pad found he is the fittest person in whole Vrindavan. Even it happens so sometime, Sanatana Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad writing some books. After writing, they give this book to Jiva Goswami Pad to edit. Now you think about the power of Jiva Goswami Pad. Rupa Goswami Pad writing, compiling books. Sanatana compiling. After they offer this book to Jiva, you can edit that book. You see the condition. This way, Jiva Goswami Pad doing seva, writing so much book, so many books. So many books he is writing, so many commentary on Brahma Sangita. And after that he is writing, Sata Sandarbha. Six Sandarbhas are there. Last Sandarbha is Piti Sandarbha, first Sandarbha is Tata Sandarbha, Kisha Sandarbha, Paramatma Sandarbha, this way Bhagavad Sandarbha, this way six Sandarbhas are there. See, compile. If somebody can digest totally this six Sandarbha, he cannot have any doubt about any Gauriya Siddhanta. He can break any Siddhanta, Vedanta Siddhanta. By Mayavadi. Any Vedanta Siddhanta by Mayavadi, he can get very easily. So top secret Siddhanta and so Bicha, so classical. Tattva Pradeep, one book, I cannot remember the name of that book, I cannot. But I think so. Ballabhacharya in his next life, he wrote one book about Vedanta, this, that. He came to Jiva Goswami Pad to get it edited. And Jiva Goswami Pad saw, this is Siddhanta is wrong. This way, some siddhanta is changed. So you see, by now, Balabhacharya have great respect for Jivapath. Now he can understand who is Jivapath. Edited by this way. So Madhu Madhav, one very nice book, Gopal Champu, so many books compiled by Jiva Goswami Pad. And one important thing for all students, those who like to get thorough knowledge about Gaudiya Siddhanta. Thorough knowledge means in practice he should do it. Thorough knowledge means not he can memorize it. Not he should practice under the guidance of Guru Pad. Both. So he wrote one Vyakaran book, Harinamrita Vyakaran. Harinamrita Vyakaran. How he got this inspiration to compile that kind of Vyakaran books? Sanskrit Vyakaran, Sanskrit grammar. How? He got inspiration from one Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. What that Leela is? When Gauranga Mahaprabhu was doing his last Leela in Gaudham, almost he is going to leave a material, family bondage is going to break. By that time, so many students coming to Nimai Pandit, and Nimai Pandit cannot explain Vyakaran properly. Properly means he is explaining properly. The student cannot understand what you mean. Like you are not speaking any, sutra, anything. Whatever sutra you speak, you always speak Krishna, 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 Krishna. What's that? In every step, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this sutra you see, ultimate meaning Krishna. This sutra you see, the ultimate meaning Krishna. Students see our Gurudev, teacher gone mad, I think. Why? He is not speaking anything about what is written in Vyakaran book. He is speaking everything about this sutra, it ultimately means Krishna. This sutra ultimately means Krishna. That time, when hearing this Leela from Nityananda, from Gadar Pandit, Rupan, Sanatan, then Jiva Goswami took decision that it is the decision of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, those students, they should not waste their time without the name of Krishna. Because Panini or other Vyakaran, if you call up, if you read, there is no name of Krishna. They can simply waste their time, long time, they are memorizing sutra. Sutra. So the procedure should be this, in such a way we should decorate. We should decorate Vyakaran in such a way so that in each and every step they are bound to take the name of Krishna. Maheshwara Sutra, this Sutra, Vamandev Sutra. So you are bound to speak. So Jiva Bhatt thought that it is the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it is the heart of my Mahaprabhu, because to implement the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it is the general rules to implement. Si Chaitanya Manavishta Swapitam Jena Bhutale. They are going to implement all Vichar Siddhanta of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They are actually eternal parshad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then you can speak. Otherwise not. So many devotees, they took Harinam from Prabhupada, Diksha from Prabhupada. They all are not the eternal prasad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prabhupada. They are not all. Some. Who? Prabhupada speaking, those who are dedicating their life to implement the heart of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are the prasad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Similar way I can say, those who are going to implement the heart of Prabhupada, they are actually eternal prasad of Prabhupada. Not that. To be frank, Narottama Thakur came late, express him late in front of us. By that time Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gone. But still Prabhupada saying, he is the eternal prasad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Why? Even he could not see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He could not meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So what? Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. How I know? One day, Bhagavati Ma came in Navadip Dham to take darshan of Babaji Maharaj. By that time, Babaji Maharaj was there in Kulia, there at the bank of Ganga. There was a small place, Babaji Maharaj doing bhajan. One day, Bhagavati Ma, you know who is Bhagavati Ma? Who? I don't want to speak that way, that's why I don't know. Bhagavati Ma came to meet Gaurkishad Babaji Maharaj and paying dandavat. Babaji Maharaj became stunned. You come here long way from Calcutta, Bhakti Vijaya Bhavan? Yes. Why you are coming? For marketing? For marketing you are coming? Or you want to see some deity, Vigraha, Darshan? No, to see you, to see me. You don't know the eternal person of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu there inside your room. Why you come long way? Why you are taking trouble? Why you are taking trouble? You are coming long way? Your eternal person of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there inside your room. Is Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This way we know. Eternal Parsad. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the eternal Parsad. Prabhupada is the eternal Parsad. They are the eternal Parsad of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This way you see, Jiva path, after Rupa Goswami path gone, after Sanatana Goswami path gone, he is just feeling heart, my heart rendering. My heart is now broken. I cannot live anymore. Day and night crying, remembering Rupa Sanatan, always crying. Then he got the chance to stay with Raghunath Das Goswami also. They have nice friendship, very nice. Raghunath Das Goswami. Some books Raghunath Das Goswami writing, he is dedicating this book into the name of Jiva Path. Sometime Raghunath expressing this desire. Krishna approved this point that I like to leave my body in front of Jiva. In front of Jiva, he is my life. Krishna approved this point. I like to leave my body in front of Jiva Goswami Path and in front of Radha Kund. Krishna can approve this point. So you see the condition. You see the condition of Jiva Goswami. You see the position. So Jiva Goswami Path. So after Rupa Goswami Path gone, Jiva Goswami Path gone, then after that, he was the total controller of Gaudiya Vaishnav society. He was total controller, unique controller. He was giving responsibility. Then after that, by that time, Srinivas Acharya came. Then Samananda Babu came, Ramchandra Kaviraj came, gradually Narottama Thakur, gradually they are coming in front of Jiva Goswami Path to take Siddhanta Vichar, Kripa. For a long time they are staying with Jiva Path to get total Siddhanta, secrecy of Siddhanta to know. Narottama Thakur, you know, Champak Manjuri. Srinivas Acharya Moni Manjuri. You can go mad who they are. After that, you see, Jiva Goswami Path giving some title to them. Jiva Goswami Path was very satisfied. Actually, Srinivas Acharya, he was the disciple of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Srinivas Acharya, he was the disciple of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Gopal Bhatta Goswami met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in very childhood. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to South India, you know? South tour, there. Sirangam, that place name is Sirangam. Now, North Madhavu took Diksha from Lokanath Goswami. Samanandapur took Diksha from Gauridas Pandit here in Kalna. So this way, they are coming all in front of Jiva Goswami to learn and learn. Though they are an eternal person, so they are taking all Siddhanta. After that, Jiva Goswami was speaking. Actually, almost 85 years, long time, Jiva Goswami was staying in and manifesting his Leela. 85 years. And out of that, 65 years was alone in Vrindavan. In Vrindavan. 65 years. And 85 years manifesting Leela. 85 years total. After that, leaving his body this day, this tithi. This tithi, leaving his body, Paush. But before leaving body, he gave a responsibility to Srinivasacharya, Ramchandra Kaviraj, Nautama Thakur, Samananda Prabhu, give responsibility to them. You take all these writings of Goswami Pad. You go and preach. Because by now you already learned from me what is the secret Siddhanta. All books. Sandarva, so many books. Even we heard, even you can see, check up. The Sanatan Goswami is Samadhi Mandir. You can see there one place is there, Grantha Samadhi. You can find one place it is in, books are giving inside Samadhi. Why? We heard from our Guru Bhargava that Grantha, rare Grantha. If it is exposed in front of common people, they are actually foolish. They are going to misunderstand Supreme Lord Krishna. They can misunderstand Rupa Goswami Pad and Sanatana. So only for the satisfaction of Krishna, maybe, they compiled that book, but they couldn't publish that book. Even Jiva Goswami Pad was so careful that if I leave one book here, if someday somebody can watch, then he can. Can he have the chance to get away? He can misunderstand. So he took decision to give Samadhi of that book. So secret Siddhanta. After that, Jiva Goswami was giving blessing. They are coming with all books, even Bulkar, you see, whole books, old books. Written by Goswamis, they are taking and coming to Bengal. You know everything. By that time, that books was books. Birhambir Raja, one king, he still was a big docket. Then there is details in discussion. I have no time. After that, they again deliver those books. They could realize. That Virambi Raja could realize that I should give back those books, manuscripts. Then today we know all Siddhanta and Vichara, all books, and now this way it was published all way. Otherwise there is no chance. Now point is that we are going to discuss some Siddhanta Vichara of Jiva Goswami Pad. This is most important. Because the time is very limited. Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish this Achinta Vidabet Tattva everywhere. In Satasandarbha itself and in different places where he put Vedanta Siddhanta Vichar, comparative statement, you can find Ramanuja Siddhanta, Madhacharya Siddhanta, Nimbarka Siddhanta, Vishnu Swami, all four Acharyas, they are having some commentary on Vedanta. But have some disparity. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to compile it very, make it harmony. and give this Achintya Vedavet Siddhanta. And that Achintya Vedavet Siddhanta was established by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and ultimately established by Jiva Goswami firmly. Jiva Goswami. Now, I am very interested to discuss about this point. Those foolish people, they have the audacity to pass this kind of remark that Jiva Pad is not in line with Rupa Goswami Pad. How dare you say? They are all foolish person. Bloody. They are passing this kind of remark that Jiva Pad is not at all in line with Rupa Pad and Sanatana Pad. Why? They are speaking that in Sandarbha and different place, Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish this Sakya Bad. Sakya, you know? Krishna got married with Rukmini, this that. In eternal world, what the question of marriage is there? Nothing there in eternal world. So Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish with Sakya Bad. But whereas Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad, they always wanted to establish Parakya Bad. So there is a big difference. So we don't understand, we cannot understand that why. Then our Guru Varga, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they are all giving evidence that it cannot happen, it cannot so happen. Jiva Goswami Pad is always with in line of Rupa Goswami Pad. Always. Even in his own books, everywhere he is writing that I am under the guidance of Rupa Pad and Sanatan, my Guru Varga, I am writing this. So somebody can speak this way. What is the exact Siddhanta? That is the main question. Because anywhere you read, Sandarbha, you can find that Jiva Goswami Pad wanted to establish, ultimately he wanted to establish this Sakya Bad. But whereas Jiva Goswami Pad always giving this argument, giving this evidence that his Parakya is eternal and how to understand this point? Now, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we can have a nice judgment. We can have Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving commentary about Brahma Sangita, different place. And you see in Bhagavatam, you can find it is written in Panchadhyay. There is one secret thing, but common people should not read it. It is the instruction, strict instruction of Prabhupada. It is the strict instruction of Prabhupada. No common devotee have the right to go through it. I can show you. Very dangerous. Even one of our Guru Varga, he was Brahmachari that time. Long time ago, 80 years back, or 90 years maybe, I cannot remember. That time he was given the responsibility to recite Bhagavatam in Bhagbayar Gaudiya Mission. That time it was one. No division was there. In the afternoon time, he was given responsibility to recite Bhagavatam. So by now he is going to touch 10th canto. Because up to 9th canto over, 10th canto, that Vaishnava, great elevator, Siddha Mahatma. But still the instruction of Prabhupada. Somebody informed, Prabhupada, that devotee, that brahmachari going to explain Bala Leela of Krishna. Why? Yeah, that much audacity to discuss Bala Leela? That Guru Varga directly speaking in front of me, my son, I never wanted to touch that Panchadhyay. Only I wanted to discuss the Bala Leela. But Prabhupada is so strict. Prabhupada said, how he is, because regarding Bala Leela, if you make confusion, if some material conception coming inside your heart, it is also dangerous. Krishna Leela is strange. Prabhupada sometimes speaking this way, Krishna Leela is so strange that common people cannot understand. They cannot understand this point. Anyway, Prabhupada was so strong. Now I wanted to prove that Jiva Goswami Pad was not at all against Rupa Pad or Sanatana Pad. It cannot so happen. How to prove it? Now, actually, Lila is Nitya. This Siddhanta you know, Lila is like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving example to Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana, Lila is eternal. Prabhu, how? Actually, Lila is like a circle, cycle, you see? One rotation, by rotation. In infinity Brahmanda, just now when I am speaking in front of you, by this time Krishna taking birth in some Brahmanda. This time, they are celebrating this Krishna's birthday today, now, just now. And to some Brahmanda, Krishna now playing the Leelas, manifesting Leela or Kaliyanak. He is giving punishment to Kaliyanak, to some Brahmanda. By now, in any such Brahmanda is there, where Krishna manifesting this Putana Leela, Putana, to give Kripa to Putana. In every fraction of second, you cannot discover such a Leela which is not present in anywhere in this infinity Brahmanda. Follow me, one. Get my point. This way, Leela is always Nitya. Maybe in this earth, I mean this our Brahmanda, this earth, Krishna just completes his Leela after the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming. 5,000 years, almost 5,500 years gone, almost. But you know it for sure, the Leela is Nitya. You can go to Vrindavan, you cannot find Krishna there. Where is Krishna? I cannot see Krishna. But those Goswamis, those who are realized soul, they are enjoying full kippa of Gurudev and Krishna, they can always find Krishna is there. Rupa Goswami Pad doing bhajan, watching Radharani. Jiva Goswami Pad doing bhajan, they can watch Radharani. Sanatan doing bhajan, he can watch Krishna everywhere. But you cannot see. You can fly up to Delhi, take the trouble to waste your money, 10,000 rupees, to pay to to Air India. But you have no right to go, enter to Vrindavan. You cannot see Vrindavan. To see Vrindavan, you will have to take the help of a realized soul. You will have to exhibit 100% Saranagati. You will have to do Nam Bhajan perfectly. Otherwise, no chance to see Krishna, to see Vrindavan. No chance. This way, you see, in Vrindavan, all creepers and trees, small trees, big trees, or keepers, they are also Siddha. Vrindavane kimapi gulman latao sudinam. Latao sudimani kripa. Uddhav requesting, oh Krishna, I like to take birth as kripa in Vrindavan. Vrindavane kimapi gulman latao sudinam. This is my request. So you understand the valuation of one dust particle of Rupa Goswami Pad. It is more and more valuable than you can get, total infinity Brahmanda, material Brahmanda. Infinity material Brahmanda you can put one side and you can put one dust particle of Rupa Goswami. It is more valuable than infinity Brahmanda. So now you cannot understand this point, what I mean to say. This is positive word. This negative one. That's why maybe infinity material Brahmanda. By valuation, in comparison, it's got no valuation. Now you see, I want to establish this point. It is already there in Siddhanta. So Leela is Nitya. You agree? Leela is Nitya, you agree? Leela is Nitya. Even in Vrindavan, now you go, you can say Krishna is there, Radharani is there. So it is called Bhauma Vrindavan, Bhauma. Bhauma Vrindavan means Vrindavan incarnate, Vrindavan coming here. in this material world. Vrindavan is not the part and parcel of earth, this material world. It is coming, it seems. The Vrindavan is there, is in UP. It is there in UP. If you go there, we can find Vrindavan. But regarding Vrindavan, you cannot pass this kind of remark. Vrindavan is not in UP. Vrindavan not in Haryana. Vrindavan is Vrindavan. It is totally detached from this material world. But still, material people find that Vrindavan is there in UP. Well, Maharaj, we too. This way, you see, this way, Vrindavan is there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Dham Mahatma, Dhamma, to glorify Dham, Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, this Dham, Navadip Dham, Vrindavan Dham, is loosely attached with this material world, not touching this ground. But it seems that it is there. In Mayapur, so many hotel, Maharaj. In Mayapur, so many hotel. Gaudiya Math said, where you find one hotel? Nowhere hotel. Nothing is there. Only in Mayapur Dham, Navadip Dham, on this pure, pure devotee they are staying. They are singing the glories of Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Where you find one hotel? So many hotels, no. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, no man, come on. Yeah. Your darshan is not perfect. It cannot so happen. In Dham is always pure. Those material people, they have no connection. They cannot have, does not have any relation with Gaudiya Math or in Dham. Same point I come back. With Dham they have no relation. They are saying, I mean Maya Devi making one arrangement so that they can feel that I am in Vrindavan. Maya Devi making some arrangement, Mahamaya, so they can feel I am in Vrindavan, I am in Navadvip. Actually they are not in Navadvip. This is the arrangement by Mahamaya. And Jogmaya always helping you to get the Leela, I mean full capa of Krishna. This way, now you agree that Leela is Nitya. So if you agree that Leela is Nitya, then you will have to agree this point, all Sakya, Parakya, everything is there manifested by Gaudiya, is also Nitya. You are bound to, Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving this arrangement, that this is Bhauma Galak. This is Bhauma Vrindavan. Bhauma Vrindavan. Vrindavan incarnate here. It is just equal to, not less than equal to, not greater than equal to. Those who are knowing mathematics, they know. Not less than equal to, not greater than equal to. It is just exactly. Bhauma Vrindavan, Bhauma Galak is just equal to that Nitya bin Nitya Golo. It's just equal. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains what is the difference you can detect here. But here, point is that there's big explanation. If I go on explaining to long time. So sweet discussion, you see.
Very nice topic. We can use next classes
also. Oh, actually, point is that Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, see man, in Nitya, in Golok Vrindavan, there, topmost there, there is no birth lila, Krishna taking birth, it is not there. But still, that kind of Baba is there, Baba. Yasodama feeling is my son. This Baba is Nitya. In Nitya, in Golok Vrindavan, all Baba, which is manifested here, that Baba is also there. That is also Nitya. Follow, it's very secret. You cannot understand this way. You have to take more and more kipa, Shaduguru kipa, to get more and more realization about this point. So there, actually, what Leela you can see, same Leela there. Only the difference, there is no Kamsa, no Agasur, no Bakasur. There is no Agasur, Bakasur. But that feeling is there. Gopikas, they are speaking, well, Krishna, we are going to Kamsa to complain, to lodge a complaint against you. Well, you can go. That feeling is there, Kamsa is there. But Kamsa is not there. Kamsa is not there. No Agasur, Bakasur, Putana, Kamsa, nothing there. But that sort of Baba is there. Baba is also Rasa Siddhi. Narottama Thakur writing in Kirtan, one Kirtan is so topmost secrecy. Nobody knows Narottama Thakur, Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika. Gorkhisar Bajma used to keep these two books, Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika, here. Nothing else. This Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika can guide you up to the last moment. I mean, Krishna Prema can give. But you don't believe. Only Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika, it is more than sufficient. To get Krishna Prema, you see, so nice of Siddhanta, but you have no time to try to discuss about it. Yeah, actually. Now, point is that, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, in Vrindavan, we cannot expect that Krishna is going to marry somebody. In Bhoomalila, it is possible. Krishna going to marry Rukini, Satyabhama, but in eternal abode, it is also eternal abode, but still, it is Bhoma Vrindavan. This kind of lila is manifested this way. Only that kind of feeling is there when Krishna manifests lila in Bhoma Vrindavan. That feeling take the form of one material. Take on material form. Follow my point. Here, that feeling take the form of some material form so that outside people can see. Otherwise, there is no difference. Actually, Radharani, you see, Ayan Ghosh is the husband of Radharani. But it cannot so happen. If there is no respective Gopikas there, respective Gopikas, there Lolita, Sakika, Lolita, Visakha, Champaklata, they have husband, and family life, they manifest this kind of lila. Chaitanya Chaitamita is written, Jogumaya arranging everything. Krishna speaking, even I don't know what is happening. It is written there in Chaitanya Chaitamita. Amiyo na jani, na jane gopi gaon. I also don't know what is happening. And gopikas, they also don't know. Without any information, everything happening. By the mercy of Jogumaya. So, even Jogamaya Upasritya, before Rasalila, it is written, by the Mahatumi, in Bhaktivinoda Thakur, written, Krishna Rasa Prakotilo Tumar Mayaya. It is written in Bengali. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Ho Jogamaya, Krishna manifesting this Rasalila by your kippa. Same thing is no different because internal process is non-difference from Krishna. Krishna is doing. Jogmaya is non-different from Krishna. So he is Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing out of love, strong love. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Krishna rasa prakatilo tumar mayaya. Even you cannot imagine because bonded people, when anything he is thinking, bonded people, Bhopat Singh, Bhaktivinoda Thakur also speak, I can show you, don't express any doubt about my. I never speak anything which is not spoken by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. There is some chain in my hand. You can see Babaji Maharaj doing bhajan solitary. No! Always some chain is there in my hand. Somebody compelling me, beating me. Hey! Do this way, that way. But you cannot find anybody. So this way you see, Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada giving same argument, and Jiva Goswami Pada, out of this conception, for the benefit of material people, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Those material people, whenever they think anything, some contamination is there, because their mind is not pure. Follow my point. Their mind is material. They are hearing Harikatha, maybe 50% clearance, purity they develop, but yet, another 50% is there. That's some sort of contamination. Maybe 80% purity is in block. 20% contamination. So if they discuss anything fancifully about Krishna, that contamination can throw them inside hell. Prabhupada speaking. Krishna Lila both at the same time can help you to cut this bondage and get prema, at the same time Krishna Lila can put you into trouble. It depends upon your own position. Your position is not same with his position. Her position is not same with her position. Everybody, according to previous Sukriti and Bhajan, they develop one kind of position, I mean rank. You cannot break it. This is Pakka Siddhanta, like mathematics. You cannot break. It is written in Bhagavatam, Sasa karye yo nistha sagunaha parikritita viparyastu dosaha. In Gita also giving, you have that much right. Krishna giving. You are not discussing Gita even. You like to jump. Gita is the basic philosophy. Here the foundation. Without Gita, you can ruin your vision life. Krishna giving detailed discussion, you see. Up to this point you have the right. Up to this point you have the right. Who they are Shudra, they have up to this point, they have the right. Who is Brahmana, up to this point they have the right. Chaturvarna maya srishta guna karma vibhagasaha tasyaham karta. I am doing everything. Chaturvarna ashram system. To control this society very smoothly, I do it. So you have no right to break it. If your initiation is done, you can get some this Yoga Sutra. Second day you manifest you are with vanity. Well, now I am Brahman, so I can go to temple and worship. I can do anything you like. Any ritualistic activities, anything they are doing, Brahman, I can also do. I have. Bhakti Vedanta, come on man, you are foolish. You are not giving this sutra to express this kind of vanity. It is Paramarthik Yoga Sutra. You can do this much. You cannot break the rule. You cannot break the system of this society. You have no right. Prabhupada speaking, I am giving them this Yoga Sutra to make them at least Brahman, so that they can at least try to become Brahman. Follow. Prabhupada, this is the mood of Prabhupada, that I am giving the Yoga Sutra so that at least in this life they can become Brahman. They cannot become Brahman, how they can become Vaishnava? So typical Siddhanta. Brahman and Vaishnava, one contradiction took place in Mindapur, Baligai. There Prabhupada strongly speaking. Vishwamarananda Goswami was there, presided over that sabha. And Prabhupada was the main speaker to break all Siddhanta of all Brahmin. They have some prejudicial conception. Prabhupada break all Siddhanta. They have the right to take Brahman initiation. It is written in Shastra everywhere. Gayatri Mantra they can get, and of course if they have some, I mean, strong resolution. Dibya Gyan, if you can misuse, in that case you cannot dig. It is one kind of medicine. Gayatri Mantra, one kind of medicine. Then one, our Guru Bhagavan speaking, medicine. To whom we can apply medicine? You are a very healthy man. Can I help medicine to you? Oh, no. Medicine is only applicable for a man who is full of disease. For disease, I can apply medicine. So Gayatri is one kind of medicine. So Guru Varga giving Gayatri so that at least you can cut material bondage and make you free from this material bondage and go up and up in realization. Up and up. Gayatri Mantra can help you this much. Otherwise, Diksha Purasharan Vijay Apekhyana Kare. Without Diksha Purasharan, you can come out successful. If you have 100% belief on Harinam, this is Sasana. The other day I was discussing this point. So now you see, in Bhauma Lila, there is Parakya Bhav, you see? Parakya Bhav, you see? Because those gopikas, they are leading their family life, at the same time they are coming to meet Krishna. It is illegal. It is not. But in scripture, I can give so many, I can discuss this point also in next class also, next discussion, because a long theory. Gopi nam tat pati nam cha sarvesham eva hidin sarvesham evam dehinam. Gopi nam, inside gopis, or inside the heart of all the husbands of all those gopis, gopikas, all same Krishna sitting. Krishna sitting? Gopi nam tat pati nam cha sarvesham eva dehinam jo antas charaha so adhyakya kirana neha deha bhag. And all other sloka I can discuss after. Very long discussion. So now, actually Sukadev Goswami, when you say Parikshit Maharaj expressing some doubt, it is one kind of lila to break our doubts, you see. Parikshit Maharaj expressing. Gurudev, atto kama yadupati hi katavana vai yugupsitam. Yadupati, I mean Krishna is self-satisfied. Why he need to go and meet with all those wives of other people? It's all illegal. It's not good. Sukadev Goswami, well, come on, what do you think? For Krishna, nothing is illegal. It is illegal for you. It is illegal for you all bonded soul. Nothing illegal for Krishna. Krishna is the Supreme Lord, Supreme Authority. Six kind of appearances, vairagya, vidya, everything. Everything there, six of them, complete with Krishna. Vairagya also. They are fully in Krishna. So now point is that you see Krishna is meeting with all the wives of, Gopal. Gopikas, they are the wives of different Gopas. The Sukadeva say, no, it is not your perfect darshan. Gopi nam tatpati nam cha sarvesha meva dehi nam. Jo antas charaha so adhyaksha kirana neha dehavad. Inside everybody Krishna is sitting. Who is Govardhan Gop? Who is Govardhan? Who is the husband of whom? Nobody. You cannot find any husband there in Golok Vrindavan. Bhauma Vrindavan you can find. It takes the form, that's those Baba takes the form of one material form. So to exhibit this Lila. In this contest, I would like to say, this Bhauma Lila is more interesting. In one sense, we discuss, you can find more interest in Bhauma Lila because there is some sort of barrier is there. So I like to discuss this point of Jiva Goswami Pad, how Jiva Goswami Pad, for the benefit of common people, those who are innocent, they cannot understand the mood of Krishna, Jiva Goswami Pad, putting this Siddhanta, that though it is Parakya, it is Sokya, is totally... I can prove it. Gradually I can show from different scripture, Praman. And what you think about Rasa Leela? You can read Leela, Krishna is dancing with all idiot. You cannot understand this one, who is those gopikas? You cannot understand. I can prove from Brahma Sangita, from different place, itself from Bhagavatam I can give evidence. Then you can go mad. Why Maharaj, we read Bhagavatam, we cannot understand this point. You can show it. So we in infinity period, nobody can pay anything to Jiva Goswami Pad. We are so heavily indebted. We have nothing to pay to Jiva Goswami Pad. Whole for infinity period. We can pay gratitude, humble obeisance unto the lotus feet of Jiva Goswami Pad. We have nothing to give. We are very poor. Spiritually we are very poor. We have no development. Actually, I like to discuss some points more about this Achintya Bhita Siddhanta, this Bhoma-lila and Eternal-lila. Discussion I am interested. But today also, you know, Jagadish Pandit, he is also the seventh Siddhi. Jagadish Pandit is the eternal person of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He used to stay in this Mayapur here, just Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Jogopit. Jogopit means the residential complex of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So just near Hiranyagavardhan, their house was there. So Chandrahas Sakhi, eternal. It is also eternal. He is the eternal person, Jagadish Pandit. His wife is Dukhini Ma. So great discussion I can have with you, but no time at present. Day after day, if Krishna bless you, you all bless me, I can go on discussing. But I cannot make up time. So time is very limited. So I cannot come all the time. So excuse me. Today also I was taking information. I think in this cold weather they cannot come. I can come 3 o'clock at night. If you call me, 3 o'clock I can come. I can meet you. But you cannot come. So this way, you see, that day when I go out of that room, I remember the sloka. I already speaking all the time. Eh? So now you have any question about my discussion, today's discussion? If you have no question also, because I am giving solution. I am putting question, otherwise I am giving solution. They cannot have any doubt, but still, if there is any doubt, you can speak. With full blessing of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and full blessings from audience, I mean, you all are hearing me. So I am getting benefit out of that. This is one kind of bhajan I am doing. Prabhupada saying it is topmost bhajan. So you give me the scope to do 100% perfect bhajan. That's why Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami worshipping the lotus feet of all audience. Sab sotar kori charan bandan. Because they give me the chance to serve Krishna through Bani Seva. So I am grateful to you all. So Vancha Kalpa Durvasya ke Basindu Vyavishyapati Dhanang Pavane Bhyo Vaishnava Bhyo Namo Namah.
Maharaj, maybe next time you can, because we also hear, we fast these things with Dham, that I speak for myself, I'm not really fully clear because there are so many things. So all this abrakat, prakat, nitya,
naimitik. You go on discussing this point.
And also maybe you can, because we heard there, Mahaprabhu, he is eternally in Nitya Lila. And there is Samyogini, Vyogini, and this Sri Radhas and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Maybe next time, because it takes more
time. I can discuss after, but in details. Our time is very limited, that's why. Ma, Ma.
Yes, Mahaprabhu is naimitik and nitya lila. This is what we'd like to hear. Yeah.
Huh, what question?
I have a question. Should we pray to Yog Maya or not?
Huh?
You said Yog Maya is the one who...
Yog Maya or Maha Maya?
Should we pray to Yog Maya?
Yes. We can pray to Yog Maya all the time.
This is not Durga Puja.
Huh? Oh, you see, same, you go to Paramatala, you know, just opposite, across the river, you're going to get that spot, which is Paramatala, Siddha Pit. Paramatala, Kulodevi Yogamaya Murekipakori, Abarang Sangbirve Tumi Vishwadori. In Bengal it is written, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. The same, in front of material people, he is manifesting his feature as Durga, Mahamaya. Shame. We are going there and praying Kulodevi Yogamaya. We are singing this way. So, when Jogamaya find you have some desire and something, you have nothing pure inside you, she can manifest it this way, Mahamaya. When you are pure inside her, you have devotion, then she can manifest as Jogamaya. She can help you to get the kripa of Krishna fully. This is the system. It's just shadow. Many times I discuss. Maybe next time I can also discuss. Ah, this is shadow. Like you are standing in against one light. So light you are standing in backside, you can say one shadow. So Mahamaya is nothing but shadow of that Jogamaya. If Mahamaya is not there, no question of any shadow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving nice example. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving this way, clarification. This way. So suppose Jogamaya, if Jogamaya is not there, then no question of shadow. So Jogamaya is the original. If Jogamaya is there, that's why this shadow, I mean Mahamaya, they are watching, material people they are watching.